it's coming back. Yeah. It's resurging back. And it's funny because when I heard you were working with Bastille, because we talked about this before, yeah. I had more of an indie image with Bastille, but you've managed to bring the R&B and fuse it together.
Yeah, you know me.
I know,
it's like, no pun the pun, but it's one of those things where on paper it was like Bastille, me, I mean, where's this gonna?
Yeah.
But I always had this feeling that there was a lane that both of us could be in that didn't feel too far removed for Bastille and also didn't feel too far removed for me. And I think that we hit the chorus together and was like, oh, I got the payoff. But then you get the drop as well. And it's like, we kept it cool. We didn't do the hands in the air, kind of go to the four to the floor thing, which is kind of, and all the pitched up vocal going high. It was like, cool. I know you, just be nice with it. And I think that's what people really resonate with.
And I think that is the art of music. That's the platform.
Yeah.
It's what you put on it. Yeah. So Bastille being more indie, coming and meeting you halfway, more R&B on the musical platform.
Yeah.
It's just magic.
Yeah.
Should we hear that now?
That's why the synergy here, Angie, is so good. We're on the same page. We got the memo way back.
We need to do lunch because there's so much to talk about, because it's not just a case of putting on an MP3 or a CD, whatever, and listening to you, because there's so many facets to you. Mm. And you were saying earlier, like 2018 is the time. My kids are, Morgan and Cameron have listened to you for years. Mm. But you're now moving into an area of music where they're now in their teens and going, Mom, have you heard of Craig? And, you know, we're talking about Bastille. We're talking about Anderson .Paak. We're talking about Stormzy, Giggs, Kano.
Yeah.
That's their thing.
Yeah.
But Mummy listened to Craig.
I know.
20 years ago. But you're beautifully positioned to just span these genres, to span these generations. And that's a great place to be.
Oh, it's amazing. And something so new and exciting for me. I mean, literally, like, just as you said, seeing 14, 15-year-old kids who are literally saying, have you heard of this new guy called Craig David?
Yeah.
And the beautiful story of the relevance of being able to be relevant to you, but also when you do go and tell your older brother or sister or your mum and dad, and then the mum and dad says, well, Craig David, let me go and pull out 7 days and fill me in on the board to do it. You're both having a conversation about me as the same artist, but relevant to two generations. And I think that, to me, is something unheard of.
Yeah.
I mean, you can... This will be the year of a lot of artists coming back round to there the first time. And you may hear them do their own song with a new rapper on it, and it'll be that. But to come with new music that actually feels like it's been discovered again, that's what I'm very grateful for. Because I know my fans who've been with me from day one, I've got you. I got you on the R&B. This, trust me, and not even just to gas the album up. It's just an R&B album that makes me excited that I want to play it. And when I did that was when I was doing Born to Do It.
Yep.
Because I didn't have reference points. I was just like, to make me feel good. Yeah, that's a good start for me. So I'm back in that place again.
Motown, soul, Philly, Stax birthed into the 60s and 70s. R&B was the 90s.
Yeah.
That was our era.
Mm.
There were some R&B artists who also took samples and beats from older hits. I mean, I should have actually prepared this, but the other day I was playing Keep Forgetting by Michael McDonald. Straight away I thought about Regulate, Nate Dogg. And
the Doobie Brothers were fire. Those guys. Yeah.
So when it comes to sampling, what are your thoughts on that? What are your thoughts about taking, I'm not going to say old samples, I'm going to say mature samples, and putting them on an R&B bed and bringing it up to date into the 2000s, the 2010s?
I'm all about it. I mean, that's the birthing of hip-hop music.
Mm.
I mean, if you look at how Kanye West forged his incredible career, he took some of that, I mean, Through the Wire, do you know what I mean? I mean, these are records that, or even Biggie when he took DeBarge and turned it into One More Chance. And then that one then took another step. Ashanti took it and went, See My Days Are Cool Without You.
Sing,
and turned it
baby.
Into Foolish. And then it would move in. So someone else is going to rock that same break and it's going to be brand new again.
Mm.
And it's a cyclical thing, do you know what I mean? So I think it's a great thing because when it's done tastefully and it respects the original in some way, and usually it's a sample that, in isolation, you wouldn't necessarily have used that part. I mean, Stan with Eminem.
Oh, man.
If you listen to even how that was more closer to the time when Dido had released the song, but he just took a part of the verse. He didn't even take the chorus. He just took a little, and then that turned into his chorus, and he had the hugest hit.
Absolutely, ever. So, absolutely. Yeah. And you know, I mean, we could sit here and talk about samples for ages, but you know, Biggie also took Juicy. I mean, you know, we could talk for ages. I was thinking the other day, Kanye touched the sky with Curtis Mayfield. Yeah. You know, we could talk for ages. Right, I received a phone call a couple of weeks ago. Ange, do you know Craig David? This was a friend of mine in New Jersey. Of course I know Craig David. He's on Sirius with Sway. And I was like, yes!
I'm telling you.
How was that?
Listen, it was when I met Sway, firstly, because I mean, I'd followed Sway from all of his stuff that he'd been doing from MTV all the way through to Eminem's own show. Literally, we were outside and we were like saying, we did a high five, and then he went down like to one knee to praise me. I went down onto one knee. All of a sudden, it was getting a bit weird because we were almost like flat on the floor, laying down, sort of like doing push-ups. I was like, bro, okay, we got mad love for each other here. Yeah. Walked in the studio, and it was just like to when he said, like, man, you've been doing this for like 17, 18 years, and the respect he had for me and starting a trend, and then for him to be like able to say to his DJ, look, go on, throw on five instrumentals and let him do his thing.
Yeah.
And I was like, it was cool. I was like, let's just go. And then the response was just, I was just like, you know what? Something special has happened.
Absolutely.
And you can't rush this thing. You know what I mean? 17 years is not something, it's not an overnight thing that it's like, oh, you had a couple hits and it's cool. Have a career is something that I'm so grateful for. And Sway really pulled that out to the American audience and let them know, you know what I mean? Listen, even if your last song from me was 7 days, if that's the only thing that you remember from me and you don't know the story, well, I Know You is the next single that he had and we're good to go.
There you go.
I love it.
There you go. Mm. So we've gone from, I'm going to say emceeing, because I know you rap, but I like MC. To call you more MC. Of an MC, a bit more classy, darling, to songwriting, performing, and now this 20-year span, tapping into a whole new audience. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to ask this, but I'm going to ask, what's next, Craig?
Do you know what? It's that an older version of me would have said, oh, I need to play this venue, or I need to sell this amount of records, or I need to hit to this chart position. Me now is in a place where I'm so balanced and so grounded that I'm just enjoying this journey right now. I'm just like, listen, I just want to make music for people to enjoy. I just want to go in the studio and lose myself, where it seems like I came in here at 9 and we're out of here at 9, but it feels like I've only been in here for like an hour. Yeah. It's gone so fast because I was so in the moment. And that's what I'm living for this time. It's like, don't worry about the next thing. It'll come. Do you know what I mean? I just want to make people enjoy. Go away saying, I had the best time at a Craig David concert. I had the best time on holiday and this was our song. And it was this Craig David tune and it was I Know You, and it will always be our memory for the next like 30 years and we'll always reminisce. That's what music's about. So I'm just in that zone.
We need to meet outside of the studio.
We will, definitely.
And we need to talk.
100%.
Perfect place to play. Talk to me.
Which part are you going to go with? That's the way. We've got part one and part two.
Oh, my God. What part do you want?
Let's go part two with LMA.
Let's do it. Craig, love you.
Love you too.